Now for a review of Nigeria's macroeconomy in quarter one and expectations into the second quarter, I'm joined by Babatunde Obani. He's a Principal Associate, Mergers and Acquisitions at UBA Capital. Babatunde, thanks for joining us today. Now let's get straight into it. We saw inflation figures down to 9.5% in February. It'd be good to get your outlook for inflation in quarter two. I mean, of course, we're still expecting figures for March as well.
The inflation rate moved from double digit to single digits, and the reasons are not far-fetched. We know that the CBN is really doing a lot within its own territory to make sure that this is curtailed, and so we strongly believe that, going by what the CBN has said, that the single digit inflation rate should be maintained throughout the year. There are possibilities of us seeing some volatilities probably as we get into Q2, now that the budget has been signed, has been passed, and you begin to see the spending on the government side, on the executive. So you reckon that the trickling of this liquidity might want to generate some inflationary pressure. But overall, this will just be short-term volatilities. For a long-term view, for the rest of 2013, we believe that the inflation should be, I mean, maximum at 10%, but we expect for much of the year it will be at the single digit levels.
Okay, now FX reserves, of course, looking good right now, $49 billion. Now, with the issues we're seeing with oil theft and now new threats from the movement of the emancipation of the Niger Delta, how big is the risk to foreign reserves in quarter two?
The risk is very, very huge. I mean, if you look at the history we've had in this country, if you look at the pre-amnesty period, when the production of oil went as low as 1.2 million barrels a day, which affected the, I mean, fiscal power of government. I mean, when you don't sell oil, we know that that's where the country generates about 85% of the revenues from. So it has a big impact. And I see that since the amnesty program was introduced in 2008, we saw a jump. I mean, it was a massive spike from the 1.2 million barrel threshold to around 2.4 million barrels. So I think there's a major threat, but I think that the federal government has, I mean, it's going to do all it takes to make sure that this threat can be taken care of. But it's going to be a major threat should they resume the attack on oil facilities in the Delta.
In your opinion, I mean, what can be done though?
Well, I think the main agitations, I mean, should just be taken care of. If the government has gone far in the amnesty program to make sure that all grievances have been monitored and have been resolved amicably, I think that that part is still available for the government to tow. Because in as much as, like I said, that this is a very crucial issue, in as much as our economy is dependent on revenue from oil, our exports, 80% of our export is from, I mean, is towards oil sector, why also the revenue comes from that. So it's a major one, and I would see the government going again to make sure that all hands are on deck to check all these threats that we're beginning to see.
Now, onto your expectations for GDP growth this year and the key drivers or risks that you see for GDP growth.
Well, we believe that the economy is going to do well. I mean, if you look at what has happened in 2012, though we started on a very weak note, I mean, about 6.3% for Q1 2012. But gradually towards the second half of the year, it went up to like 6.5%, 6.48% to be precise. But it ended on a very strong note in quarter four. And we are optimistic that this trend can be sustained, because what we've seen, if you look at the composition of the GDP, pretty much like 40% of that is coming from agriculture. And the flood that happened in the middle belt in the first, I mean, quarter one last year and like mid-year really affected productivity of the agri sector, which also cascaded to the GDP as it were. But since this thing has been taken care of, we've seen a massive response from the Ministry of Agri. The Minister of Agri is doing a fantastic job. Mm-hmm. And we believe that all the effort that we're putting in 2020 will begin to yield the results. So we strongly believe that the economy should be able to do the 7% mark this year. Also, when we look at the services side, like if you look at the result that we've seen, the performances of the macroeconomic constituent, because let's not, by the time we look at the macro, it's good to also break it down to the micro, mm-hmm. because the macroeconomic unit makes up the aggregate of the micro, exactly what we call the macro. So we've seen the performance of the listed companies, we've seen the performance that has come out in quarter one and for the pretty much towards the end of last year. So we believe that this momentum can be sustained, and we are very optimistic that barring any unforeseen circumstances, the 7% GDP growth rate mark is very much achievable in 2013.
Let's talk about currency now, Babatunde. I mean, what about stability of currency in quarter two? I mean, as you said, oil price and oil production, of course, will be key. What about outflows by foreign portfolio investors?
Well, I think there's many factors that are coming into play when we're looking at the currency. Like rightly said, they want to look at how much we earn from oil, how much petrodollar comes into the economy, and how much reserve do we have to defend the currency. And that also now takes us to what the CBN can do at the WDA's auction. I mean, how much to supply and how much to demand. Because pretty much what we're seeing now is just is determined. The currency price is determined by the forces of demand and supply. So pretty much barring all these things, I mean, factoring all these parameters, we see that the CBN will go out to defend the currency around the 3% mark that it has set out at the beginning of the year, because the action we've seen in Q1 has shown that the CBN is very, very serious with this objective of defending the currency, which they've done pretty well in Q1. I mean, it ended on a very strong note, and we so much believe that the CBN will continue with this momentum for the rest of the year, in as much as we also know that FDI is very important to our economy.